Hi, I'm David Morris, CEO of Delano's Coffee Roasters. We started our company in February of 1992. Our company will do nearly $24 million in sales this year. We have approximately 75 employees, led by me as CEO, Christopher Heyer as president, and Howard Heyer as chairman of the board. We currently roast over 3 million pounds a year. We have approximately 1,500 customers, and nearly 70% of them are out of our state. From premier espresso machines to syrups and cups, Delano's delivers regionally and ships nationally over 600 coffee-related products. We have state-of-the-art product warehousing and roasting facilities totaling 45,000 square feet. At current roasting facility capacity, growing at 20 to 30% per year, and adding an additional daily roasting shift, Delano's will be able to roast over 10 million pounds a year before considering a new or additional facilities.
Okay, everybody, welcome to the Monday morning meeting. Woo!
I also want to say thank you. There is no one else in our donor sponsorship family that does quite what Delano's Coffee Roasters does. There's not another corporation that we know of, unless they're secretly doing it, that makes part of their mission reaching out to needy children and linking children with employees in the way that this organization does.
I think it's really important, you know, the ending message for you guys, like we were hearing in the Christian Children's Fund, is that you're part of a global community. And a lot of times when we get into our work and we're busy doing what we do, whether it's packaging or roasting or selling, we can get so enraptured in our day-to-day life that you don't realize that every little thing that you do is directly related to everyone in the supply chain across the world.
Debbie, because I know she's been hauling butt all week. She's
been on the phone. Because our mission statement is to, everybody,
help people make friends and have fun.
A lot of coffee companies today have a major focus on sustainability and creating relationships with farmers. At Delano's, we have a major focus on that as well, but we take it a step further and really look at supply chain sustainability and looking how we can balance the profits that are made in coffee across the board. So we've created a segment of our coffees called One Harvest Project, and coffees that are in this project are direct relationships where I travel there at least once a year to talk with the farmers, to talk with the managers of the co-ops.
One of the projects we have going right now is with the Kinyovu Cooperative in Tanzania. The farmers there border the Gombe Reserve, which is where Jane Goodall did her chimpanzee research. We provide cupping education to these farmers to help communicate to them what the specialty market is looking for. We have also organized to have experts in agronomy and water conservation come to the Kinyovu Cooperative to improve quality and yield. These improvements raise the value of the coffee on the market, dissuading any encroachment on the Gombe Reserve, as well as improving the quality of life for these farmers. One additional project is one that we have going with the Rio Azul Cooperative in northern Huehuetenango in Guatemala. This extremely rural community high in the mountains has been producing superb coffee for years. One of the things that the members of this cooperative were lacking was the means for medical attention. With a $10,000 grant from Delano's, all 150 families have access to medical and dental coverage. With support from Delano's, we have seen steady increases in the premium paid for Rio Azul coffee, as well as the production of organic coffee from this cooperative. Over the years, this relationship has been rewarding not only for the farming members at Rio Azul, but also for the people who are able to enjoy their coffee. Our real focus is on quality, not only quality of the coffee, but quality of life for our partners at the growing regions. We talk a lot about helping people and making friends here at Delano's, and customer service is also very important, and that all starts with a relationship. But rather than just focusing our relationships on our customers, we also focus those relationships backwards up the supply chain to the farmers.
That's a very crucial part of this operation, not only for the sustainability of the earth and of the growing practices of these farmers, but the sustainability of our quality as our company grows. More and more, it's getting harder to find quality coffees, and so these relationships really give us an edge in looking for that.
So, as you guys know, I just went to Tanzania. It was a trip that was basically organized to go and do exploratory operations on creating relationships with the Kinyovu operation, a cooperative that we work with over in Tanzania. But if we can create a relationship and really show those consumers that this cup of coffee is a Tanzanian Kigoma that's from the Kinyovu cooperative, and you see a picture of Tengali working with the growers there and teaching them exactly how to better their lives through quality improvements, suddenly that cup of coffee is no longer just a luxury that you have in the morning. That cup of coffee becomes really a meaningful charitable act.
Today I wanted to see if we can implement a proper dosing technique while at the same time minimizing waste. It's going to be a key concern for a lot of our customers.
At Delano's, education is very important. Not only do we educate our customers, but we also have a lot of focus on educating our employees. So we have a lot of opportunities. In fact, it's one of our core values to improve our knowledge of the industry. And so one of the recent programs we've developed is called the Cup of Knowledge. We actually have a booklet that we go over that's a 2-week-long course where we go through cupping and pairing and really dissect the art of tasting coffee. And so members of the company that graduate from this course get their own Delano's cupping spoon with their name engraved on the back. And we also have a plaque in our cupping room where they're recognized for their passion for coffee and their dedication to finish the cup of knowledge.
When it comes to our commitment and involvement in the coffee industry, Delano's really does stand apart from other roasters in North America. We felt it was our responsibility to not only educate our customers, but to take an active role in educating the industry. So we do that in a number of ways. First of all, when it comes to the coffee magazines that we're all familiar with, Fresh Cup, Tea and Coffee, Specialty Coffee, just about every month you'll find an article either written by one of our Delano staff members or one of our customers that we work with. And we don't do that just to promote Delano's, we do that to help educate the industry. Additionally, consistent with our commitment to the industry, we have a real leadership role in what has become really the paramount coffee education seminar in America, and that's Coffee Fest. As you know, Coffee Fest is held in 3 parts of the country every year. So David oversees all of the educational programs, from paid seminars to the free seminars. I introduce all the speakers, and 7 of Delano's staff members provide seminars. That's pretty incredible, isn't it? One thing I did want to focus on, though, and that is the paid business seminar that our staff oversees at Coffee Fest. This is really the most comprehensive digest that takes you from everything in terms of financial management, menu planning, staff development, virtually everything about your business. And so many of our customers that we now have went through this business seminar that we've provided the industry and now are very successful franchisors.
We're coming to you here from Delano's state-of-the-art roasting facility. Here, we are working very hard throughout the week to bring you the very finest in coffee. These beans are the fruit of our labor, where we're perfectly balancing the art and the science. We bring the latest in technology, and we also bring age-old traditions of roasting in order to produce the highest quality coffee for our customers that are in all 50 states.
When it comes to innovations in marketing and business practices, Delano's literally wrote the book. When we sit down with a customer, we train our sales staff to be more than brand coaches. We need them to be business coaches. We now write a column every other month in Tea and Coffee called The Brand Coaches to help educate coffee house and drive-through and kiosk owners from coast to coast on the right practices to build a powerful brand. From our books on branding to our books on culture, to the training seminars that we do at Coffee Fest, Delano's is really at the top of the game when it comes to innovations in marketing and business building for our customers.